I'm Jonathan Morrison, the Administrator of the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, or NHTSA. I'm joined by Dr. Aaron Hutter, who's an expert and an engineer that focuses on the mechanics of the human body. So Aaron, what is this that we're looking at today?
Well, this is our dummy that we call THOR. She is our latest and most advanced small female dummy that we are using in frontal crashes.
So why do we need crash test dummies in the first place?
Well, we need crash test dummies to help keep occupants safe. They can measure loads and how the occupant interacts with the vehicle during crash tests, and then auto manufacturers can use that information to design safer vehicles.
Why is she special?
Well, she is very special because she was developed using primarily female data so that in a crash, she moves like a woman would. NHTSA recently published a study that looked at fatality rates, and we did show that in modern vehicles, women are still slightly more at risk for a fatality than male occupants. Additionally, more of our research has shown that women are at risk for different injuries. She has a lot more sensors than our previous dummies have had. If you look, you can see in her arms, she's got little sensors that we can measure the loads going through her upper and her lower arm. If you look at her legs, and this is one of the areas I'm very excited about because we know women are more at risk for these lower extremity injuries. And so we have a lot more instrumentation and sensors. So we can look at everything from, you know, brain injury to looking at her collarbone, her face, thorax, her abdomen, pelvis, hip. We can look for forces in the hip as well as the knee and the ankle, which were all things we couldn't look at with our previous dummy.
So how can an automaker use this dummy to design safer vehicles that can account for unique injury risks for women?
So automotive manufacturers can use her because she is so much more human-like than our previous dummies. They can understand better how she's interacting with the seatbelt and the vehicle interior, and so they can make changes to those if needed to help protect these female occupants better.
So NHTSA recently has made public a whole host of technical reports and details about this dummy, giving specifications for dummy manufacturers and automakers to use. What are we doing next?
Well, the ultimate goal is to start using THOR in NHTSA crash test programs. So this is just the first step in a somewhat lengthy process to make that happen, but we are on the road to getting her there, which we're all very excited about.
How long have you been working on this dummy?
Personally, I've been working on this dummy for about 8 years. Early development started back in the 90s, but concentrated development started in 2015 for this dummy.
So the previous generation dummy was developed in the 1980s. How is this different?
This dummy is different because, one, she was developed using mainly female data. So we looked at how female occupants actually respond in terms of, you know, the compression of their chest or the motion of their ankle, and we modeled her response off of that. Additionally, she has much more measurement capability. So she has over 150 sensors, where the previous dummy that we've used in frontal crashes has only had about 50.